Johnny heated one up as well. They both held their bottle tops with tongs and pressed them against the coating of ice, melting two holes where they could see the reflection of their eyes. "Look, John, look through my hole. What are you seeing through yours?" "My eye, of course. What else?" At first, John had thought she was imagining things, that it was the hunger that constantly gnawed her stomach, making her see things. But there, in the mirror, there was a little bee buzzing, with snow on its stripy body, carrying a little jar of honey between its wings. "You're dreaming, though you're awake. You've probably got a bit muddled-headed with all that staring into the mirror," said John. "No, it's real. I can see a bee." The children's granny had told them fairy tales about bees that were so realistic that the twins could see them in front of their eyes. But this bee wasn't a fantasy. It buzzed out through the hole in the ice, settled on the gold frame, and opened the jar.
"Here. I realised you were hungry, so I brought you a bit of honey. It might help. You each get your own spoon as well."
The bee took two little spoons out of a tiny bag that hung round its neck and gave them to John and Jonna. "We're only dreaming. You're a fairy tale that Granny told us," said John to the bee.
"Taste the honey then. You'll see whether it's just a fairy tale."
The twins dipped their spoons into the jar and stuck them in their mouths.
"Wow! That's the most delicious honey I've ever had. If I've ever eaten any before," said Jonna, tasting the sweetness spreading in her mouth. John couldn't bring himself to say anything. He just ate and ate, the way he used to eat his granny's sponge cake.